Hi, I'm Lorna with the University of Missouri Extension Master Gardeners of Greater Kansas City. If you have any connection with roses, chances are you've heard of rose rosette disease, or maybe you've heard someone call it witch's broom. Rose rosette disease is a deadly disease and is becoming more common. So in this Tuesday quick tip, we'll tell you what it is, what it looks like, and what to do about it. So what is rose rosette disease? It's an incurable disease caused by a virus that is spread by the microscopic areophid mite. These mites are invisible to the naked eye. They drift on the wind, coming into your garden, onto your roses, and infecting the rose bush with the virus as it feeds. A non-infected mite landing on an infected rose bush can pick up the virus and then is blown on to infect the next rose that it comes in contact with. The disease isn't new. It was first identified in the 1940s and was likely spread across the country on the wild, invasive multiflora rose. In the last 20 years, landscapes have exploded with mass plantings of new, easy-to-care-for roses. And with those mass plantings, insects and diseases were easily spread. So how do I identify rose rosette disease? While the symptoms may vary between rose species, generally you can identify the disease by noting these common symptoms. Foliage and shoots will have a red color. Now, healthy new shoots on a rose bush are also reddish, but healthy shoots will quickly green up, while the infected shoots will remain tinted with red. Shoots will seem longer than normal and especially thick. The stems will be covered with thorns. It's an obvious overabundance of thorns, not spaced out as you would see on a normal rose stem. Leaves and buds may be distorted, deformed, or discolored. Buds will be malformed, may never open, or there may be no buds or flowers at all. You will see the namesake witch's broom growth on many stems and leaves overgrowing into this odd growth pattern. Herbicides can cause many similar symptoms. Roses are fairly sensitive to herbicide drift, and drift can occur over a surprising distance. The thorniness and reddish color are not herbicide related though, so if this is on your symptom list, you can probably assume rose rosette disease is on the bush. If you've determined your rose has the disease, what do you do next? Once your rose has rose rosette disease, there's nothing you can do to save it. Many growers and homeowners try to keep the rose by pruning off the infected sections, but you won't be able to prune it away, though it can be worthwhile to start with pruning as an option that confirms the disease when the symptoms return. So what do you do if you have a diseased rose? You should dig the entire rose bush out along with all of its roots. The virus will be in the roots, so clean up the debris and trash the entire plant. If there is any good news, rose rosette disease only infects roses, and it does not remain in the soil, so immediately replanting with another rose will be fine. An integrated pest management, or IPM, strategy is a multi-step approach to managing rose rosette disease. Monitor your roses daily, looking for the symptoms we've discussed. Take action by pruning and discarding any suspicious stems. Watch for returning symptoms. Record your actions so you can confirm if symptoms return. Use IPM preventative strategies. Scout your yard, especially if you have a wild area. Remove any invasive multiflora roses within 100 yards of your other rose plantings. That's a football field away. Minimize the use of leaf blowers around your rose plantings to help keep any mites that may be there in place. Don't overcrowd your plantings. Intermix other plants to provide a break between your roses. Keep your roses healthy with proper cultural care, which includes watering, pruning, fertilization, and cleanup. It's a battle without a solution yet, but roses are too important to give up. Be vigilant and follow the guidelines. Do your part in keeping healthy plantings. Thanks for watching. Drop us a comment or question below. Subscribe to our channel to see all of our videos. And until next time, we'll see you in the garden.